Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. We begin today with one of the most contentious issues in Wisconsin politics, mining. With a legislature dominated by Republicans in 2013, passage of a bill that would reform the state's mining laws looks likely. Then again, that's what we were saying earlier this year, and it didn't happen. The mining company, Gogebic Taconite, wanted to build a huge iron ore mine near Hurley in northern Wisconsin. A bill to streamline the permitting process cleared the assembly, but it got hung up in the Senate on the objections of a single Republican senator. GTAC pulled out, but some say it could be lured back. Next month, Republicans will have an 18-15 majority in the Senate, enough votes to pass a bill. Democratic Senator Tim Cullen has been leading the Select Committee on Mining, and we're joined today by Senator Cullen and Scott Manley, Vice President of Government Relations for Wisconsin Manufacturers and Commerce, which backs the Assembly mining bill from last year. Thanks to both of you for being with us today. I'm going to begin with Scott Manley. Is this the single most important piece of jobs legislation the legislature is likely to take up?
We think it is, and we look at the economic development potential for this bill, and if this project goes forward, we're talking about literally 2,000 construction jobs to build the mine, and then once it's up and operating, probably 700 jobs at the mining site and another 2,000 or so scattered about the state, including right here in the Milwaukee area, where we have two world-class mining equipment manufacturers in Joy Global and Caterpillar.
Do you see it as being front and center in the next legislative session?
Well, it's important, but it isn't going to result in jobs in the very near future. We've got an investment capital bill. We've got some changes in the educational system. There are other things that we're going to be doing that I think can have a significant impact on jobs in the next couple of years. But this is certainly a long-term important matter in terms of economic development.
Let me follow up briefly on what Scott Manley said. You have told me in the past you think you might be talking 5 or 6 years down the road before these jobs would be created. Not necessarily the jobs if you were building a mine, but 5 to 6 years, it's a long time.
Yes, it is, and that's not a number I made up. This is what we learned in the committee that I chaired. We heard that number from the Army Corps of Engineers, who has a co-equal power in permitting a mine in Wisconsin, and we also heard from the head of the Wisconsin Mining Association, who told the Milwaukee Journal it was probably 5, 6, or more years. This getting a mine permitted, especially in this environment where this mine site is in southern Ashland County, is doable, but not easy.
Give me your sense, Scott Manley, on what you think is going to happen in this legislative session. It didn't happen last time because of objections by Dale Schultz, a Republican, and of course there were no Democrats in the Senate supporting it either. But is it absolutely certain to happen this time around?
Well, I've been doing this long enough to know that nothing's an absolute certainty up at the Capitol, but I think things look very positive. I think we've had an opportunity to do a better job of explaining exactly what's in the bill. There was a lot of misinformation and I think confusion out there last session about some of the environmental impacts of the bill. I think we've been able to address some of those and demonstrate where a lot of those concerns were just not justified. And I think it really is teed up between leadership in both houses and the governor making very favorable comments about the need to get these jobs created. I think it's going to pass.
Senator, you have said your mining committee, you want to find some consensus here. You want to get some Democrats on board, any Republicans who might have doubts, Indian tribes. How are you going to do that? What recommendations are you making that you think could be part of legislation that would make this a more acceptable enterprise?
Well, first of all, I don't think it's clear, this 182-page bill that Scott supports, it isn't clear to the legislature, let alone the general public, all the changes that are in there to our environmental laws. It's not clear. What I do hope happens, I'm drafting a bill right now, which is a result of what I learned and the committee learned in 20 hours of public hearings from experts from all across the mining spectrum, from the Mining Association to WMC, the Wildlife Federation, the regulators, the Army Corps of Engineers, the Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources. We talked with the Minnesota DNR. And we're trying to put together a bill that acknowledges that it's difficult but possible to get a permit in that area, but you can't ignore that there are other players who have significant say in this. It isn't just the Wisconsin legislature. I think one of the problems with their bill is that it assumes that the DNR, we can pass a law and we can control how fast mining occurs. At the end of the day, we're going to have a bill in January. Scott and his supporters are going to have a bill in January, and the legislature and the public are going to have a chance to compare them. And I think until that happens, I think there's still going to be a lot of, well, my bill's fine or my bill's fine kind of stuff. And I think put side by side, I think we'll actually have the comparison that needs to happen.
Let me have you address that, because he's saying that there need to be changes in the legislation. You tend to favor something that's more like the assembly bill, at least as a starting point in this conversation. Do any changes need to be made to what was considered last year?
Well, you know, I think we're open to looking at changes, and we'll certainly be interested in seeing what Senator Cullen comes up with when he introduces a bill next session. But I think there was a very long list of people, including our organization, that Senator Cullen listened to over the course of the summer, and that's very commendable. But those of us who are focused, and I think Senator Cullen is, on getting this mine done and getting reasonable reforms done to our mining laws, we have to be cognizant of the fact that there's a company out there that wants to make a $1.5 billion investment. And if we can't come up with some reforms that create an acceptable permitting process that has the speed, the clarity, and the predictability that makes them comfortable making that investment, we're never going to create these jobs.
Let me have you respond to that, because the question is this, you might be able to create a piece of legislation that's acceptable to Democrats or acceptable to the Indian tribes, but at the end of the day, if the mining company says it's not acceptable to them, they don't want to be here, what's the point?
Well, first of all, the mining company, all they've ever asked for publicly was some certainty in the permitting process. Today, the law, it could go on forever. Their bill, I think, is unreasonably short. We have a time frame in our bill, which will bring some certainty, which is what
2 years
is what they
asked
for.
Process, right.
But there's really two pieces to the legislation. One is the permitting process, how long it takes and so on. But then there's whether or not there are any changes to the environment. Because you've got to figure out, at the end of the day, when you dig up 20% of what is iron ore, and that's what they want. There's 80% that's not iron ore, which we call overburden, or they call it that in the mining industry. People would call it waste, dirt, and rock. Where are you going to put that? And the mining company, through their bill, is less concerned about where that goes. But where that goes, if it goes into water, it comes up against our Constitution. And then if you put anything in the Bad River, which flows downstream from the mine through the Bad River band of the Lake Superior Chippewa's reservation, they have enormous rights and power backed by the federal government, going back to the treaties that put them on the reservation.